Hello everyone and thank you for joining my talk today. My name is Varshni Subhash and I will be presenting our paper titled as GPU Parallel Computation of Morse-Neale Complexes. A Morse-Neale complex is essentially a topological descriptor that succinctly captures the gradient flow of a scalar function. This framework allows for multi-scale topological analysis and visualization of large scientific data. Morse-Neale complexes are widely used in a number of application domains such as cosmology, biology, and material science, to name a few. In order to combat the exponential growth in data and increasing feature complexity, it becomes essential to devise efficient parallel algorithms for the computation of this descriptor. To give you a quick flavor of what a 2D Morse-Neale complex is, let us consider a sample scalar function which consists of a number of peaks and valleys. The critical points, namely the maxima, minima, and saddles, correspond to the points where the gradient of the function becomes zero. The Morse-Neale complex is the partition of this underlying function domain into regions of uniform gradient flow behavior as described by the integral lines shown. Existing techniques for the computation of 3D Morse-Neale complexes adopt serial or hybrid approaches which incur large runtimes for bigger datasets. This work focuses on addressing this gap with contributions as follows. We introduced the first completely GPU parallel pipeline for the computation of Morse-Neale complexes with our method achieving speedups of up to 7x over existing parallel approaches. We do this by targeting the major bottleneck of saddle path computation. First, we introduce a novel technique to mark saddle reachability by utilizing vector operations. Next, we present an algorithm to count paths between saddles by leveraging matrix multiplication based graph traversal. The computational pipeline for this task consists of four steps. The first step assigns gradient pairs which we borrow from the state of the art by Shivshankar et al. Further, these gradient pairs are used to locate all critical points. The third step, which is the primary bottleneck in existing approaches, involves the computation of saddle-saddle connections. The fourth and final step computes extrema connections in parallel, which we again borrow from Shivshankar et al. In this work, we incorporate incremental improvements to step 2 and focus the bulk of our attention on step 3, which poses the biggest challenge in terms of performance. Do note that we extensively leverage data parallel primitives such as prefix sum and stream compaction offered by the library Thrust, details regarding which are available in the paper. To zero in on the challenges encountered in step 3, consider the directed acyclic graph that represents the collection of paths between all one saddles and two saddles. An example of this tag is shown in the 3D grid setting on the right, with the dark green cell represented by a two saddle and the light green cell corresponding to a one saddle. The paths between these 1-2 saddle pairs undergo multiple splits and merges as shown, which leads to an exponential growth in the number of paths. The best known algorithms use serial variants of a breadth first search, with the fastest method making use of a priority queue. A trivial parallelization is possible, but this fails to scale well. Our work aims to improve upon these methods by introducing a parallel algorithm which reduces step 3 to an embarrassingly parallel task. The first task is to mark reachable paths between 1-2 saddle pairs by conducting a BFS traversal. Our parallel BFS algorithm iteratively computes and stores a frontier of nodes that are reachable from all source nodes, which in this case are the set of 1 saddles. During a given iteration, the current frontier discovers the next frontier, and each discovered pair is represented by P in the graph shown, with invalid pairs denoted by hashes. In this example, the second iteration will consist of the stream compacted set of valid pairs discovered in the first iteration, and these nodes will go on to discover the next frontier. The algorithm terminates when all paths reach two saddles and the frontier becomes empty. The next task at hand is to reduce the saddle path counting problem to one that is amenable to parallelism. We do this by constructing a minor of the DAG by contracting all simple subpaths, a transformation that gives us nodes that are either one saddles, two saddles, or junction nodes. Here, a junction node denotes a node whose out degree is greater than 1. The construction of the DAG minor is initiated in parallel by considering all one saddles and junction nodes as sources. Each path is traced in parallel, and the destination node can either be a two saddle or a junction node. Since these are simple paths, each path is guaranteed to reach its destination without splits, and the final step involves the storage of each unique source destination pair by the corresponding thread. The final step is to count all paths between saddles, for which we leverage matrix multiplication based graph traversal. As shown, any graph can be represented as an adjacency matrix A, which when multiplied by the source vertices V gives us AV, which is the frontier discovered by the sources. We utilize CU sparse for all matrix multiplication operations, a choice that facilitates maximum scaling while avoiding a large memory footprint. Specifically, consider the DAG minor whose nodes may be placed in levels from 0 to n as shown. We first multiply edges connecting levels 0 and 1 with those connecting levels 1 and 2 to obtain edges connecting levels 0 and 2. Performing this iteratively in parallel and storing the newly discovered nodes in a storage matrix A star gives us the final set of nodes connecting one saddles at level 0 with junction nodes at the highest level. Further, we multiply A star with connections between junction nodes and two saddles to obtain all connections between one saddles and two saddles. We perform a final addition of matrix D, which accounts for simple paths between one saddles and two saddles. We performed computational experiments on 9 popular datasets and mention some salient results here. Our BFS algorithm achieves speedups of up to 129x as seen in the dataset foot. The path counting algorithm performs better for larger datasets with the highest speedup of 4.5x as seen in aneurysm. We observe speedups ranging from 1.33 to 7x for the overall Morse-Weil complex computation. With that, I'd like to conclude my talk. Thank you for your time, and if there are any questions, I'd be happy to take them.